Yes, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Plays and Fades, Week 14 edition. Let's get you started with the quarterback I like this week. Remember, strictly for tournaments, Russell Wilson. Russell Wilson is ridiculously underpriced. FanDuel, more so than DraftKings, adjust their salaries depending on the matchup. Russell Wilson has accounted for 94% of the offensive touchdowns for the Seattle Seahawks. A lot of people are going to see the Jaguars on the other side, and they're going to stay away from them. Moving on over to running back, the most popular play this week, Giovanni Bernard. 5,100 on FanDuel for a running back that's probably going to get every single touch in that backfield. Obviously, this all depends on Joe Mixon's status. Be prepared for him to be chalk, but also be prepared for him to smash. And at 5,100, you can get a lot of elite plays on your lineup. Next up, one of my favorite wide receivers this week, Josh Gordon. Josh Gordon last week saw 11 targets. This dude hasn't played football in 3 years. And according to Pro Football Focus, the number one corner in the NFL is Casey Hayward. Casey Hayward, after the game, came out and said that he was the toughest matchup he's had all year. This is a guy that's faced Dez Bryant, Alshon Jeffrey, Odell Beckham Jr. And he said, this dude, off the couch, best matchup he's had. Josh Gordon last week saw 34% of the target market share on his team. Third highest of any wide receiver on that slate. Similar to what we said about Giovanni Bernard, he might be super popular, but for their price and what it does for the rest of your lineup, you gotta play both guys. Next up, another wide receiver I like this week, Doug Baldwin. We know about Bouye and we know about Ramsey, but we also know that they don't play on the inside. Both guys stay on the perimeter. On the inside is Aaron Colvin. Russell Wilson and Doug Baldwin are going to be on their own because of the matchup against the Jaguars, and I like both this week. Next up, another wide receiver that I like this week because of the return of my boy, Sterling Shepard. Also, we need to monitor if he's going to play this week, popped up on the injury report, but if he does, one of the great things about Sterling Shepard and the tight end we're going to mention soon is you know where the ball's going on that offense. Sterling Shepard in his last 5 games has seen over 8 targets in every single one, and that includes the start with Geno Smith. Eli Manning comes back against a team in Dallas who, let's face it, is one of the worst teams at defending opposing slot wide receivers. Love me some Sterling Shepard this week. Next up, pivoting off Shepard, the tight end we like this week also, Evan Ingram. Pretty much everything I said about Sterling Shepard applies to Evan Ingram. Dallas is 28th in DVOA at defending opposing tight ends. And the best thing about the Giants offense is that Shepard and Ingram account for close to 80% of the target market share on that team. Moving on over to the fades column. The quarterback we're staying away from this week, Cam Newton. Cam Newton this week plays arguably the best defense in football in the Minnesota Vikings. And what do we say about defenses? They travel. Cam Newton is still not 100%, battling a sore thumb issue. And at his price on FanDuel, I'm just pivoting to other places. Moving on over to a running back that we're staying away from this week, Leonard Fournette. Leonard Fournette draws a very tough matchup against one of the best run defenses in the NFL in the Seattle Seahawks. The Seahawks are allowing the 4th fewest rushing yards in the NFL this year. Knowing how Seattle plays defense, they're probably gonna stack the box to make Blake Bortles have to beat him. And anytime you build a big lead on the Jaguars, they can't run the ball. So I think game script might not be in Leonard Fournette's favor this week. Next up, a wide receiver I'm staying away from, Mike Evans. Tampa Bay might be without 2 of their starting offensive linemen. Jameis Winston simply doesn't have enough time to drop back to get the ball downfield to players like Mike Evans and DeSean Jackson. Mike Evans hasn't had a 100-yard game all season, and he hasn't scored a touchdown in the last couple of weeks. I'm staying away from Mike Evans. Next up, another wide receiver I'm staying away from, Sammy Watkins. Seems to be on the fade section pretty much every week, but a lot of people still play him because Robert Woods is out. The wide receiver you want from the Rams, Cooper Kupp, and even Josh Reynolds is seeing close to 79% of the snaps week in, week out. Last but not least, the defense I'm staying away from this week, the Buffalo Bills. The Bills are priced up because they're at home and they're playing the Indianapolis Colts. One thing that worries me is Tyrod Taylor might be out this week, and if he is, that means Nathan Peterman is coming in. 5 interceptions he threw against the LA Chargers, which led to a lot of short fields for the Bills defense, who gave up, I believe, negative points on FanDuel. For their price, I think they are ridiculously overpriced and I'm staying away from them. So there you have it, guys. Plays and fades for week 14. Before we go, new announcement. We have a Facebook page up. The Facebook is facebook.com/veteransminimum. Everything that comes out of Veterans Minimum will be on that page. Make sure to follow. And if you want to hear more about DFS, Degeneration Bets, DFS podcast, every Friday coming at you, more in-depth look at the slate. Catch you next week.